banquet of God's reign, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the people of St. Antoninus Parish, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
If we could close our intercessions as we pray our Archdiocesan Vocation Prayer. Almighty Father,
you have created us for some definite purpose. Grant us the grace to know the path you have planned for us in this life, and to respond with a generous yes. Make our archdiocese perish as long as it parts, fruitful ground for your gift of vocations. May our young people respond to your call with courage and zeal. Serve among our many desires and strength, with good and holy grace. Bless us with consecrated religious, and those called to a chaste life, for obedience and faithful love.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. We offer sacrifice now in supplication, O Lord, to honor the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to the heavenly realms. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Father, almighty and eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Dennis, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, the people of St. Antoninus, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you this sacrifice of praise and of offering themselves and all who are dear to them for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, paying their homage to the eternal God living and true.
Celebrating the most sacred day on which your only begotten Son, our Lord, placed at the right hand of your glory our weak human nature, which he had united to himself, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days for your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O Lord, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Sacrifice the spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and bless and receive the peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who seek to rise to a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
From the whole Lord we pray, and all sleeping in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. Ask also your servants, who those sinners, hope in abundant mercies, gracious and ransomed prayer, in fellowship with the holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Nicias, Alexander, Marcellus, Tira, Teresa, Edwin, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, in all your saints, admittance we beseech you into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power
forever and ever. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Mighty ever-living God, who allow those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for a moment. Celebrate our 75th anniversary, there is an incredible artifact display at the Holy Family Room, and it's well worth taking time to look at 75 years of history of our faith here at St. Antoninus Parish School. And so the artifact room in the Holy Family Room is open throughout the day, so be sure to check it out. The Athletic Club Festival will be next week on June 7th, 8th, and 9th. Saturday, June 8th, Vigil Mass will be at 3 o'clock p.m. instead of 4:30 p.m. There will be no confessions on Saturday. St. Antoninus Parish needs your help to adopt a plot of landscape you care for it during the spring, summer, and fall months. See the bulletin or the display in the greeting room for details. We see the bulletin for information on the capital improvement campaign called Raise the Roof, Cool the Crawl. Gym roof must be replaced, and the undercroft HVAC unit cannot be repaired. Please help us with any amount of donation you can. In advance, thank you so much. We're celebrating 75 years as a parish. I understand that today we have some of the sisters with us, the Adrian sisters, Adrian, Michigan, Dominican sisters. So sisters, where are you? Please stand or raise your hand so we can say thank you. And sister, please share with the Dominican sisters that you have planted fantastic seeds of faith here in our parish. This year, we graduated the 70th 8th grade class at St. Antoninus Parish School. The class is 2018. Well, thank you so much, sister. Thank you to everyone who has been so marvelous at organizing this fantastic celebration. Certainly want to thank Mrs. Hank Delaney and the beautiful music with which the musicians provided for us. So thank you so much. Thank you to the ushers, lecturers, Eucharistic ministers, servers, my fellow priests, Deacon Bob Schrader. Thank you very much. We are so grateful that you are here with us. We want to thank two people especially, Sue Horn and Sylvia Loneman. The two of them have been working together for a year with their team to get everything organized. One day they wanted to put together this artifact display, so I chose wisely. I showed them the storage room in my office and all the cabinets, and I just stepped back and said, help yourself. So they did wonderful work. So thank you so much. Bishop Visitor, thank you for being here with us today at the Principal Celebrant and reminding us of the importance of the faith that is strong here at St. Antoninus. Thank you.